Steve Lesser walking up to the microphone now.
Now, hopefully he's got some charming anecdotes for this episode.
You know, he doesn't even ask if he's allowed to cuss on this thing. Just fires away. You love to see it.
Yeah, a real potty mouth on this guy.
Oh, shit. What happened?
Yeah, I don't know. I wasn't looking.
Steve, this is a 12-minute podcast. It's not longer than 12 minutes. I'm going to ask you a bunch of questions. If you want to answer them, that's cool. If you don't, just tell me to go fuck myself. What's a sound that you love? When you hear it, you're like, that's a good sound.
The crack of a bat.
Oh, like a baseball game.
Yeah.
Nice. Like a square rip.
Yeah, right on the heart, because it reminds me of...
You were a baseball player?
Yeah. And when I hear it, I feel it. And there's not... You kind of get it when you hit a golf ball well.
Yeah.
Or you hit it like tennis racket right square in the.
It's a wooden bat though, right?
Well, wooden or metal. But like the wood bat makes a satisfying crack.
Yeah.
And there's something about it. And so when that happens and I'm at the ballpark, I feel that. I feel like I just hit it.
Do you go to Do you go to the minor league baseball games?
Yeah.
Do you go to major league at all when you're on the road? Or
I haven't. The last one I saw was the White Sox.
Gotcha. You grew up a baseball kid?
Yeah.
Who was your team? Mets?
I was both teams Canadian. So my
okay,
yeah,
really?
Yeah, it was Montreal Expos and then Blue Jays. So that was my National and American League teams.
That makes sense.
And the team that I really adored was the Expos, because I was like a Gary Carter fan and a Tim Raines fan and an Andre Dawkins fan.
Yeah.
Andre Dawson.
Yeah, there was a Dawkins, though.
Yeah,
the Hawk.
Yeah.
That Expos hat was nice, too.
Oh, I love that. Yeah,
it's such a good
hat.
I
love the logo for
it. It's an all-time great hat.
Yeah. I went. My dad took me up for my birthday. He brought me and a bunch of friends up to Montreal.
Really?
And we just loaded up the car, and he got, instead of getting like
station wagons,
it was just an Oldsmobile.
Yeah, okay.
And there was three of us in the front and four of us in the back. So it was a long drive.
How old were you?
I was probably maybe like 14 or 15.
That's pretty cool.
And when we got there, instead of getting multiple rooms, my dad got one room and we were all in a huge suite.
Yeah, oh,
he's
nice.
Like, it's cheaper to get a suite than get a separate room.
Yeah.
But we were short on pillows. And so my friend, Jim, we called down and they only speak French.
Right.
And so they send somebody up to the door and my friend Jim was like, I speak French. I've been taking French in middle school and high school. Right. I got this.
Yeah.
And he holds up a pillow and he goes, two pillows. All right, man.
How was the game?
I remember very little about
it.
Yeah, so...
Is the other stuff that was...
Yeah, I mean, I've been talking about this a lot. A lot of my memories of those events, I adore the things around the event more than the actual event.
Yeah.
So I remember hanging out with my friends, playing cards in the room, and I remember walking up in Olympic Stadium to our seats. But I don't remember anything of the game.
The game at all, yeah.
Yeah.
Interesting. So it's always like that with good men. What's the most fun you had as a kid? Do you, and maybe not the most fun, but just like what's like that, I guess, is probably, I should have asked this question before because you just answered it. But like, what's the, as a kid, what's like a really, I don't know, it's very playful.
We had
being a kid is cool type of thing.
Oh, I didn't know anything about being cool.
No, you didn't have fun though.
No, I had fun. There's two things that come to mind. Right, I really enjoyed hanging out with my friends. So
yeah,
you know, I always described my best friends as friends that I could spend 24/7 and we'd never get sick of each other.
Right.
Right. And so I was fortunate to have
that's cool
a crew where we could do that all the time and. Didn't matter what we were doing.
Yeah.
So, lots of fond memories of, like, hanging out with my friend Pepper.
Hell yeah.
I'm just giving everybody my...
Any friend named Pepper is pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, Pepper's a great friend name.
Yeah. I'm just giving everybody my password questions.
And what was your first pet's name, Steve?
uh, uh, Pascal. We'll just go with that. That's not right. Yeah, just to throw you off. We used to get on our bikes and ride on the Erie Canal Path.
Okay.
And so Pepper passed away a while ago. Mm. And when I went up for his funeral, I borrowed my brother's bike and I was going to ride out to where we used to camp.
Yeah.
And because he was like a Boy Scout and he knew, like, he would just essentially say, step aside, I got this.
Yeah.
And then we'd have a tent and we'd sleep in the tent.
Nice.
And when I was there, I realized that that was 47 miles away.
Yeah. Oh, no shit.
I was like, holy shit.
Yeah.
I was in high school and we were biking 47 miles on the Erie Canal Path mostly. Then we go off and off the path at the end. And it was just insane. I had no idea we were that far away.
I thought about, like when I was like 12, 13, 14, I would hop on a bike and just ride from city to city to city. And now that you said it's 47 miles away, I have no idea how many miles I used to just be able to go. And now I get on a bike. I got a mile. I got to sell the bike.
That's exactly kind of what happened. Yeah. I got on the path and I'm riding and I was like, whew, I got to be getting close. And I checked the map and I was still 46 miles away, like that. And I was like, all right, I'm just going to be here on the path and go home and honor him.
I have two questions here. One, what is an age, as you're right around the same age as I am, what age of your life, calendar year, how old were you, what was the most fun year you had, start to finish?
I was having when I was 27, that was a good year.
What happened?
That's a good Jenny year.
Yeah. Right?
So we got married when I was 28, but 27 we were dating and engaged. So I got engaged. I was having a good time performing. I was having a good time in grad school with my buds. And so, you know, just was a lot of fun. Pretty active playing sports and doing all the things that I love doing and very little of what I didn't like doing.
Yeah. Yeah. That's nice. Yeah, getting that time.
That's hard to argue against, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
That's not a good age.
Yeah, hell yeah. What's a year, what age was like toughest? It's the most difficult
year. I don't think I had a difficult year. I've had difficult times, right? Because like emotionally there's like these things and they don't coincide with a year necessarily.
Sure.
They might be seasonal, but they don't, right?
For sure.
You know, I had a tough time when my dad died. That was some shit times. It was weird because I was actually best when I was crying. So, because what was making me cry were the things that were like the beautiful moments, the good things.
Yep.
And if I wasn't crying, I was dwelling in the horseshit part of it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And so like it was actually a good thing if I was crying because that meant that I just had a real sweet memory.
Yeah.
And I missed them, you know.
Yeah. So difficult. I haven't dealt with that. That's someone. Have you always been a crier? Oh, did that experience.
I started being a crier when I started having kids, when we started having a family.
Yeah.
I don't think I cried as like a grown man until then, but then different things started to, and it was usually I'm more of a happy crier.
It's like feeling of like, it's just that joy, that appreciation.
Yeah. 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 And it's, you know, it's funny because if I go to the movies with Jenny, we might both cry at the movie, but at different parts.
Yes.
She's crying at the sad parts.
Yeah,
and
And
then when it turns out well at the end, I'm like,
yeah.
She makes fun of me I forgot. There was some like silly mermaid movie and like it ends up with this goofy ending. And she's like, are you crying? I was like, this one I'm not. And she's like, you're crying at this one. Yeah. Luca.
When your dad passed and you had that, when you're going through all that stuff, if you could go back right now and talk to you when you were going through that for like 30 seconds, what advice would you give? What would you say?
That's a great question. I'd say, I don't know. I don't know if I would have handled it any differently, right? Because if you lose somebody important to you, it's hard not to have feelings. Why would you not have feelings? And I think you got to experience both of them to do it kind of healthy. I think there was so much that I learned from when Jenny's mom passed, because that one hit us hard too, mm-hmm. really hard. Because she was she lived with us. She was, you know, I felt sad when my grandparents died, but they were external to the core family.
Yep.
That was the first time like it felt like home. And so I learned a lot from that. But, you know, I'm not sure I would say anything different. Like, I don't think I handled that one. I've done lots of things poorly, but not that one. Yeah, I think I grieved all right on that one.
Good, yeah.
I just was surprised at how long it took.
Right.
You know, so maybe I would have given myself the heads up, like, you know, there's no rush.
No rush, yeah, no time. Yeah. We got 10 seconds. Do you love yourself?
Sometimes, but not always.
That's all you can do? All right, that's that.
Cool.
Thanks, bud.
Thank you. Good. Love you, man.
Love you.
Thanks for bringing me into
it. Yeah.
All right, that was fun. Yeah, it's good. It's like this.